next what we are going to see is how to evaluate the given postfix expression. So the algorithm for that is, first you have to scan the input expression from left to right. Then while you are scanning, you each and every character, each character you have to check whether it is an operand. If it is an operand, push it into the stack. If the scanned input is an operator, then pop the top two values from the stack and do the set performance, set operations of the operator. But if it is a plus, you do the addition of those two operands. If it is a minus, you do the subtraction between those two operands. And then after then, there will be a result note that you have to push it back into the stack. Repeat about two steps till all the characters are scanned. After all the characters are scanned, there will be only one element in the stack, and that is the result of the given expression that you can print out. Now we'll see that with an example. Now if you see that this is the given postfix expression, we will see how to evaluate this according to our algorithm. First, you have to scan from left to right, each and every character. Now while scanning, I have to check whether it is an operand or operator. Now this is an operand. So whenever I see an operator, I have to operand, how to push it into the stack. Now the next is also an operand. So I am pushing it into the stack. Now I am seeing an operator. Now what you have to do, you have to pop. While popping, it will be placed in, I am keeping two variables, OP1 and OP2. So the first variable, I keep it in 3, OP1, and then the second operand, I pop and assign it to the variable OP2. Now since I have popped, these values have gone. So I just remove this. Now according to this, you have to add these two. So now OP2 plus OP1, it is nothing but our value 8. So now I push that value. The result will be, according to algorithm, you do the operator and then there will be a result that you have to push back into the stack. Now there's already a stack is empty because I have popped those two. No, so now I push back the values, the result. Now the next character is 6. Now I, since it is an operand, I push into the stack. The next is 2. That also we push into the stack. The next is an operator. So now what you do, you have to pop the values and place it in this variables. So the first value 2, I am popping and then writing it in OP1. Then the second value is popped and then that will be written in OP2, stored in OP2. Now OP2 minus, it is nothing but minus. So now, sorry, this is a, it's not minus. The operator which we have coming across is a division symbol. So you have to do the division. So OP2 minus OP1, which is nothing but 6 divided by 2, which is nothing but 3. So that you, I am pushing back into the stack. Okay. Now the next value we are scanning is nothing but multiplication symbol. So what you have to do, you have to pop the top two location. So when I pop this, this becomes 3 and this becomes 8. Now do the multiplication. Now what you do, you get 24. So since we have popped these two, I'm just removing this. So after the multiplication, you have 24. So that we are again pushing back into the stack. Okay. Now we are scanning the next character. It is nothing but 3. And now since it is an operand, we push it. Another one is also, it is also an operand. So we push it. Now the next one is star. Now what happens? You have to pop the top two operand. So now what will be the value? It is 5 and 3. So 5, 3. Now this is a multiplication. So 5 into 3, you get 15. So since we have popped, let me remove all these things. So what is the latest value? 15. So now the next character scan is plus. So it is also an operator. So now pop these two values, put it in here pop it. So now you have to move these two values because of the popping. So here the pop value is 24. Now you add these two. So what happened? This nothing but now the operator is plus. So you add these two and you get the answer 39. So now you push this to the stack. Now the expression is also over. So now what you do, pop this value and print it as an output.